Open heart surgery has been great for more than half of a century. The problem with open heart surgery is that you have to have surgery. My name's Robert Lederman. I'm an interventional cardiologist at the NHLBI Intramural Research Program. The most common way to fix aortic valve stenosis is open heart surgery to replace the aortic valve. We try to accomplish what surgeons do using catheters and without opening up patients. Femoral artery access works very well for about 90% of people who need transcatheter aortic valve replacement or TAVR, but for the remaining 10% of people, the arteries in their legs are either too small or too diseased to allow that approach. Our team have developed this new technique called transcaval access for TAVR. That means poking a hole into the largest artery in the body, the aorta, through a neighboring vein in the abdomen. Transcaval access takes advantage of an observation from nature that all the organs in the body are bathed in a fluid that has slightly higher pressure than the blood that flows through the veins. So if we poke a hole in the artery and leave it that way, of course there will be bleeding. But if we poke a hole in an artery without using surgery, and we also poke a hole in the vein nearby, instead of there being blood accumulating outside the organs, bleeding will spontaneously drain into the vein. When we first developed the procedure, it had never been offered to patients at all. In 2013, my old friend called me and said he had a patient who was very sick, in fact dying, in the intensive care unit because she needed TAVR, but she had no options at all. He asked me to come over and teach him what we had learned in the lab. So I flew over in July 2013 and walked he and his team through the procedure and then helped give some guidance and feedback when they first applied it to the first patient. So far there have been, to our knowledge, 400 cases on three continents at over 50 different medical centers using valve devices from five different manufacturers. In order to help patients benefit from the transcaval technique, we're working hard to make the technique easier for physicians and safer for the patients. We're making a specific device to close transcaval access ports that are safe, retrievable, and immediately stop the bleeding or the connection of blood flow between aorta and vein. I think the transcaval approach stands to help thousands of people a year, assuming it becomes widely adopted. It's one of the most gratifying things in the world for a scientist or physician to invent a new technique and have it adopted by lots of physicians and used to help take care of hundreds of patients. That patient, by the way, from July 2013 is still alive even now, 4 years later.